Class 8 Science Workshop of Lesson number 11 Human Body and Organ System. Question 1. Find out my partner. Group A, Group B. Answers are given. Number 1. Heartbeats 72. Number 2. RBC 50 to 60 lakh cubic millimeter. Number 3. WBC 5000 to 6000 per cubic millimeter. Number 4. Blood donation 350 ml. Number 5. Normal body temperature 37 degrees Celsius. Number 6. pH of oxygenated blood 7.4. Question 2. Complete the following table. Organ system, circulatory system. Organs and functions. Heart. Function: it pumps blood throughout the body. Blood vessels. Function: it transports blood throughout the body. Organ system, respiratory system. Organs and their functions. In organ, nose. Function: filters air with the help of air and mucus. Pharynx. It conducts air to the windpipe. Windpipe. Function: allow passage of air into lungs. Lungs. Function: carries out exchange of gases. Diaphragm. Functions: it lowers and rises up, helping in inhalation and exhalation of air. Question 3. Draw neat and labeled diagrams. This is the diagram of respiratory system. Look carefully and draw it neatly in your notebook. This is the diagram of internal structure of heart. Draw it carefully and labeled. Question 4. Explain with reasons. A. Human blood is red colored. Human blood contains red blood corpuscles that have an iron containing red colored pigment called hemoglobin. This iron molecules bind to oxygen, which gives it bright red color. Hence, human blood is red colored. B. Upward and downward movement of diaphragm occurs consecutively. A muscular partition is present at the base of thoracic cage. This partition is called as diaphragm. It is present between the thoracic cavity and abdominal cavity. The ribs rise up and diaphragm lowers, causing decrease in the pressure on lungs, due to which air moves into the lungs through the nose. The ribs returns to their original position and diaphragm rises up, due to which the pressure on the lungs increases and the air move out from the lungs through the nose. This continuous upward and downward movement of diaphragm is necessary to bring about the breathing. C. Blood donation is considered to be superior of all donations. Blood transfusion is needed in various situations, like when a person meets with an accident, during surgeries, in case of patients of anemia, thalassemia, cancer, and also after childbirth. Regular blood donation will ensure the availability of safe blood wherever and whenever needed. A person who donates blood may be the recipient in the future. Blood donated by a healthy person can save the life of needful person. Thus, blood donation must be done without any exceptions, so it is considered as the best donation. D. Person with O blood group is considered as universal donor. Person who donates the blood is referred as blood donor. Person of the blood group O can donate the blood to the person having any other blood group. For example, O, A, B, AB. Thus, a person with blood group O is considered as universal donor. E. Food must have limited amount of salt. Eating food with high amount of salt increases the blood pressure. This leads to health problems like hypertension. To stay healthy and prevent such disease, one should consume food with limited amount of salts. Question 5. Answer the following questions in your own words. Explain the functional correlation of circulatory system with respiratory, digestive, and excretory system. Circulatory system performs the function of transport of various substances like water, hormones, oxygen, soluble nutrients, and waste materials through different organs. Oxygen inhaled during respiration reaches alveoli and diffuses into the blood. Carbon dioxide, a waste product of cellular respiration, diffuses into the alveoli. It is transported into the bronchioles and reaches the trachea. From there, it is exhaled out of the body. The organs of the digestive system need the circulatory system to transport nutrients to the body cells. Blood carries nutrients from the wall of alimentary canal to each cell of the body. Blood also carries nitrogenous waste. In this manner, different body systems work together to perform body functions. B. Explain the structure and function of human blood. Blood is red-colored fluid material. It is fluid connective tissue. The oxygenated blood is deep red colored, salty in taste, and its pH is 7.4. Blood is composed of mainly two components, one plasma, two blood cells. Number one, plasma. Plasma is pale yellow, clear, slightly alkaline fluid. It contains water, proteins, inorganic salts, and other components. Albumin distributes the water all over the body. Globulins, protection. D, fibrinogen and prothrombin help in blood clotting process. Inorganic ions control the function of muscles and nerves. Blood cells. Red blood corpuscles. Small circular enucleated cells. These cells appear red due to hemoglobin. Oxygen dissolves in blood due to hemoglobin. 50 to 60 lakh RBCs are present in a cubic millimeter of blood. RBCs are produced in red bone marrow and live for about 100 to 127 days. White blood cells. These are large nucleated and colorless cells. 5,000 to 10,000 WBCs are present for cubic millimeter of blood. WBCs are produced in red bone marrow. WBCs act as soldier in our body. These cells attack the pathogens entering our body that protect us from the microbial disease. Platelets. These are extremely small and disc-shaped. 2.5 to 4 lakh platelets are present per cubic millimeter of blood. Its function. Platelets participate in blood clotting process. Functions of blood. Transport of gases. Oxygen is transported via blood from lungs to body tissue and carbon dioxide from tissue to lungs. Transport of nutrients. Blood transports nutrients like glucose, amino acid from the wall of alimentary canal to each cell of the body. Transport of waste material. Blood carries waste material to the kidney for excretion like urea. Protection. Antibodies formed in the blood protect the body from microbes and other harmful particles. Transport of enzyme and hormones. Enzyme and hormones are transported by blood from the site of their production to the target site in the body. C. Explain the importance and need of blood donation. Blood transfusion is needed in various situations like an accident, during surgeries, in case of patients' anemia and cancer. Regular blood donation will ensure the availability of safe blood wherever and whenever needed. A person who donates blood may be a recipient in the future. Thus, blood donation must be done without any exceptions. Blood donated by a healthy person can save the life of a needful person. Hence, it is considered as the best donation. Question 6. Explain the differences. Arteries and veins. Which carry blood away from the heart in arteries? Veins carry blood toward the heart. Arteries. Blood vessels do not have walls. Veins. Blood vessels have walls. Arteries are thick-walled. Veins are thin-walled. Arteries are deeply situated. Veins are superficially located. External respiration and internal respiration. We will see the difference. External respiration occurs in the lungs. Internal respiration occurs in cells of the body. External respiration, oxygen from lungs moves into the blood. Internal respiration, oxygen brought by blood is given to cells and tissues. External respiration, carbon dioxide from various parts of the body is transported through blood. In internal respiration, carbon dioxide from cells and tissues is transported through blood. Question 7. Which health parameter of blood donors should be checked? Number 1. Illness. The donor should not be suffering from any communicable disease. Number 2. Age. The donor's age must be between 16 to 17 years. Number 3. Weight. The donor's weight should be minimum 45 kg. Number 4. Pulse. The pulse rate should be 60 to 100 beats per minute. Number 5. Blood pressure. The blood pressure of individual should be near normal. 120 per 80 millimeter of mercury, indicating that the donor is healthy. Number 6. Body temperature. The body temperature should not exceed above 37.5 degrees Celsius. Question 8. Fill in the blanks using appropriate words given in the bracket. A. RBCs of the blood contain hemoglobin, an iron compound. B. Diaphragm present between thyroid and abdominal cavity. C. Cardiac muscles are involuntary. 4. pH of oxygenated blood is alkaline. E. Production of RBCs occurs in red bone marrow. Question 8. Find odd one out. A. O. K. A. B. B. Odd one out is K, because A, O, A, B and B are the main blood groups of human blood group system. Blood plasma, platelets, blood transfusion, blood corpus. Odd one out is blood transfusion, because without blood transfusion, all are the components of blood. Trachea, alveoli, diaphragm, capillaries. Odd one out is capillaries, because without capillaries, all are the part of human respiratory system. Neutrophils, globulins, albumins, prothrombin. Odd one out is neutrophils, because without neutrophils, all are the proteins in blood plasma. Question 10. Read the following paragraph and identify the disease. Today, her child became 1.5 years old. However, that child does not seem to be healthy and happy. It was continuously crying and gradually becoming weak. It has shortness of breath. Its nails have become blue. Answer is asthma. Question 11. Your neighboring uncle has been diagnosed with hypertension. What should he do to keep his blood pressure within normal range? Making lifestyle adjustment is a key to maintain normal blood pressure. Number 1. Eating a healthy diet. In order to manage blood pressure, one should limit the amount of salt in the diet and consume less fat-containing food. Number 2. Regular exercise. Regular exercise can help in maintaining weight and lower the blood pressure. Number 3. Managing stress. Techniques like meditation, listening to music, etc. can help in managing the stress. Number 4. Avoiding alcohol and smoking. Both these habits can increase blood pressure and the risk heart attack. Thus, they should be avoided. This way we can be control our blood pressure. So friends, thanks for watching my this video. If you have yet not subscribed my channel, then please subscribe and don't forget to comment. Your comment is my inspiration.